In this session, we are going to discuss operators in SQL. So like we have operators in C and C++, like addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and, or, not, everything we'll also have in SQL also. For example, if I want to add addition of two employee salaries, so what operation I want to perform? Plus. Similarly, so like that, if you have any conditions over there in your queries, we are going with the operators. So here we have different kinds of operators in the SQL. We'll see one by one. An operator is a reserved word or a character primarily in SQL statement in a where class. Now, that means what? Where you are going to use these operators? These operators are used in where class. That means after writing where, what we write? We specify a condition. So there you are going to implement the operators. We can call operations or we can call operation. Such as comparisons, arithmetic operations. These operators are used to specify the conditions, whatever the conditions you have in your query. So that will be the operator will be used there in SQL statement and to serve as a conjunctions for multiple conditions in a statement. Now we'll know when you practice one by one, we'll come to know what is this operators and how they will work. The first one is arithmetic operators. Next, comparison operators. Next, logical operators. Other than these operators, some more other operators are there in SQL. Now, first we'll see arithmetic operators. So, in SQL, arithmetic operators are nothing but addition, subtraction, multiplication, all you know. Now, assume that you have a variable A and you have a variable B. In a variable A, I have a value 10. In a variable B, I have the value 20. Okay. Now consider this is one column. This is column 1. This is the column 2. So two columns I have in my table as A and B. Now A is holding the value 10. B is holding the value 20. Now operators we are explaining here. First one is what? Plus. Plus nothing but what? Adding the value. Adds a value on either side of the operator. So if you write A plus B, it indicates what? 30. Okay. Next, subtraction. Subtraction, right hand operand from the left hand operand. So that means this is a right hand operand. This is a left hand operand. So this right hand operator value should, left hand value should be subtracted from the right hand. So what you are getting? A is holding what? 10. B is holding what? 20. So what is the minus value? Minus 10. Next, multiplication means what? 10 into 20. Next, division means 10 divided by 2. So 10 divided by 2 means nothing but what? It gives the remainder as, so it gives the quotient as 5. Yes or no? So that means when you say division, it gives a quotient. When you say division, it gives the quotient. So one more we have, that is modulus. So we have modulus means what? Whatever the remainder is there, when you divide, that becomes what? Modulus operator. So up to this only. So modulus operator is specified as this. So if I say A modulus of B, so what is A here? 10. So 10 modulus of B is 20. Is 10 is divisible by 20? No. So what is the remainder? 10 only. For example, say if I say 20 by 2, so what will be the output? The output will be the 10. Why? Because we are using division. If I say 20 modulus 2, so what will be the output? 0 will be the output. That means here you will get the quotient as the output. When you take modulus, remainder will be your output. Clear? So this is the difference between division and modulus operator. Next we go for another operators. So you have many number of operators here. So SQL comparison operators we call. Comparison means what? If you have two things, then only you make a comparison. either which one is bigger, this one is bigger, which one is smaller, which one is higher, which one is shorter. That comparison is here. Now, first, what? Equal comparison. So you have a variable A, variable B. Same example I'm considering here. You have the value as 10 in A, you have the value as 20 in B. Now, equal operator means what? I want to check whether equal are that. So A and B both are same or not. Here, if I say A is equals to B, what is the 10? 10 equals to 20. So is both are equal? No. If both are equal, it returns the condition as true. If not, it returns the condition as false. Right? So if yes, then the condition becomes true. If not, condition becomes false. So in our example, that is not true. So in SQL comparison, it gives either true statement or false statement. So in this case, condition is false. Next, we have not equal to. So not equals to means what? Both are not equal. So if I say A not equals to B, 10 not equals to 20, is the condition true or not? Yes, 10 not equals to 20. In this case, the condition is what? True. Next, less than and greater than checks if the value of two operands are equal or not. If the values are not equal, then the condition becomes true. So for the not equals to, the same things will here. Though not equals to this, you can also use not equals to this also. Not greater than, not less than. That means what? Not equal. Next is what? Greater than. So greater than is nothing but what? Left operand should be greater than the right operand. Then the condition becomes true. So here the value is what? A is 10, B is 20. 10 greater than 20? Not true. So this also returns what? False. Here the condition returns true. Next, less than. So A less than B. 10 less than 20. S, the condition is true. Greater than or equal to. So what is the difference between these two? Here just you are comparing greater than. Here you are checking greater than or equal to. So is 10 is greater than or equals to 20? No, false. Next one is less than or equals to. A is less than or equals to B. 10 less than or equals to 20. Less than condition is satisfied. So no need of equal condition. For example, A is holding 20. B is also holding 20. In this case, what will happen? 20 less than or equals to 20. So we are considering equals to also. 10 equals to 10. So here the condition is true. If I consider 20, if I not consider as 20, A is only 10. So there what happened? 10 less than 20. So see, there also condition is true only. This one is not less than. Not less than means what? Greater than. Not greater than means what? Less than. So these are the different comparison operators in SQL. Now, SQL logical operators. Actually, here the logical operators are and, or, not. So these three are specified as logical operators. Remaining operators are said that other comparison operators, but I'm listing all at the one place only. Okay. So logical operators are and, or, not. These three are the logical operators. Remaining all are other comparison operators. Now we'll see one by one. First you have all. So all means what? All the values should be consider without having any condition. The all operator is used to compare a value to all the values in value set. For example, I am taking a value as 10. So here I have a list of values 1 to 10 numbers. Right? Now, I want to compare this 10 value with all the values of these 10. So you say, right, all. That means what? This 10 will be compared with 1. This 10 will be compared with 2. This 10 will be compared with 3. This 10 will be compared with 4. This 10 will be compared with 5. And so on up to 10. That means one value is going to compare remaining all the values in a particular column. Okay, right. Now next, AND operator. So whatever the examples are there for this, I'll tell you in the next session. AND operator. So AND operator means what? Two conditions. For example, I have where class, right? So in this where class, I have to write two conditions. For example, the employee designation is clerk, right? Employee designation is clerk, and employee salary must be 4000. So what is the two conditions have? I want to display some of the employee details who are clerk and their salary must be 4000. What you are writing? You are writing two conditions of one table. So there what you have to specify? AND operator. One condition is clerk and another condition is salary of 4000. Okay. Next, any operator. So any is nothing but what? Quite opposite to all. All means what? All the values are compared. Any means what? Any one of the value will be compared. The any operator is used to compare a value to any applicable value in the list of as per the condition. So greater than, less than, with any and all, you have some examples. I'll tell you that in the next session. Next, between. So between is nothing but what? For example, there are numbers between 1 to 10. That means including 1, including 10. What are the numbers are there? They'll consider as between. Now, I want to check this 10 is existed between 1 to 10 numbers or not. That means what? From this 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 10, whatever the values are there, those all I am considering. Consider in a set, I have 1 to 100 numbers. 1 to 100 numbers I have. But I don't want to check this 10 with all the numbers. Only from 1 to 50 numbers only I want to check. So what is the condition? 10 should be checked between 1 and 50. That means 1 to 50 numbers only I want to compare. Next, what? Exist. Exist is nothing but whether this 10 value is existed in this list of values or not. That means this 10 is presented in 1 to 100 numbers or not, we can check with the exist. For example, Rakesh is a student, is there in our table. Is Rakesh is existed in the student table or not? I want to check. So with the help of exist keyword, we can check this. Clear? So this is about exist keyword. You have next in. In is nothing but what? Whatever the value we have there, that all to be in of that only. So here, in operator is used to compare a value to a list of literal values that have been specified. I want to check this 10 is presented in 1, 2, 4, 10, 100. So that means here what you are taking, here you are not taking all the values from 1 to 10. Whatever the value I'm specified here, is this 10 is presented in the specified values or not? I want to compare. So that is in operator. Next you have what? Like operator. So like operator is used to check the names. For example, I want to check the names whose name starts with A or whose name ends with S, whose name have H. So if you have any comparison of like this, we go for like operator. Next you have not. Not means what? No. Right? So not operator reverse the meaning of logical operators which existed used. Not exist, not between, not in. So between means what? 1 to 10, 1 to 100, 1 to 50. Not between means what? Not 1 to 50. That means 51 to 100, you can check. 1 to 50, you're not able to check. So here between what we have discussed, 1 to 50 numbers has to be checked. 10 is existed or not. This is a between case. Not between means what? From 51 to 100 you have to check. Next you have OR operator. OR means if you have two conditions, if you want to check only one condition, you go with OR operator. Now here AND is quite opposite to OR. Here and means what? The employee designation is clerk and employee salary is 4000. If I say or here, what will happen? It will show the results as employee clerk maybe designation, employee salary maybe 4000. This is one condition. This is one condition. Out of these two conditions, if any one of the condition is satisfied, then it gives the result into our result set. Next is what? Is null. So is it contains null values or not is specified by is null keyword. Clear?